Welcome back to 120 Minutes. Tony Halliday from Curve is here. Now, so far, Tony, Curve have been lumped in with bands like Ride and Lush, the so-called shoegazers or blitz rockers from England. Is that a fair comparison, or are you doing something pretty different?
They're all doing something different. You know, I mean, it's ridiculous. It's in the minds of the journalists in England, and they just end up looking like fools at the end of it because, you know, people go and buy these records and use their ears to listen to these records, and they realise that these records don't sound the same, you know. And I think that the confusion that's involved in it is that, you know, there's a similar attitude that goes on, you know, with these people who make these kinds of records. They're not prepared to just put up with any old thing, you know. They want to push themselves, they want to expand, and they want music to expand in the same way, in the kind of music that they do. And the attitude's similar, yeah, but I mean the music isn't similar because they're all doing highly individual things as far as I'm concerned.
Do you think that's kind of a recreation of the punk attitude in a way?
It's really, I mean, but that started with, you know, like Acid House, really, with that whole thing of kids getting together, getting tiny bits of equipment and going into their bedrooms and making records for 500 quid, you know, and that was a really punk kind of ethic. So it's introduced in England, especially with the dance, with the, you know, the kind of more hardcore kind of acid house dance, you know, and then rave, you know, the next thing that took off, you know.
What's your personal musical background? Curve is not your first band, right?
No, it's my third band. But, well, our influences for both Dean and I are you know, really varied. I mean, we try not to have any restrictions about music. We just like good music and we don't like bad music.
Okay.
And you know, we just try to be quite open-minded about, like, for Dean, for instance, all his influences come from Bootsy and Funkadelic and, you know, the Beatles, the Stones, or, you know, just, you know, right across the board, T-Rex, you know. And mine started with my mother's influences, obviously, which were like Leonard Cohen, Joni Mitchell, Stones, the Beatles, the Beach Boys, all that kind of thing. And then when we're making our own decisions, you know, in our teenage years, when we're actively going out and spending our money buying these records, you know, I was more into like Patti Smith and, you know, Nico and, you know, all those kind of things. And Dean was into, you know, whatever, you know, Marble Giants.
Young Marble Giants.
Yeah,
whatever,
okay. Yeah.
Well, let's see if we can hear any of these influences on the first video from Curve's first album, Doppelganger. This is the first video from Doppelganger, and it's called Fait Accompli. Accompli from Curve. Tony, what inspired the lyrics on that song?
I think it would be rather foolish of me to say, you know, I knew exactly where the lyrics came from in any of the songs that we write. I mean, I try not to analyse it too much. I like the songs to be available for people to make their own, you know, assumption of what, you know, the song means to them. And I don't really like to dictate too much. You know, I've no real idea where they come from, I could tell you. I've never known, you know, and I'd never question it or try and analyse it ever. You know, I'm just glad it's there.
Fait Accompli is the first video from Curve's first album, Doppelganger. We'll be talking more with Tony in the second 60 of 120 Minutes. Welcome back. Tony Halliday from Curve is here. Tony, Curve are a two-piece, is that right?
Well, no, not strictly, because Dean and I are the main nucleus of the band, and we write all the songs, actually, not the majority. And we're the writing nucleus of the band, but the band is actually a five-piece band with Alex and Debbie on guitar and Monty on drums. And you know, they're very much part of what we do as well. You know, so, but Dean and I write all the stuff.
I noticed that you were voted number one sex symbol of the year on Melody Maker. How do you feel about being, you know, a rock front woman? Do you think you might be a role model for a lot of young girls out there?
I hope not. I really hope not. No, I mean, I don't really. It's ridiculous assumption, really, and I think that there's always been really strong women in rock anyway. I mean, Patti Smith being one of them, and Annie Lennox and Deborah Harry, and, you know, really powerful women, you know, who've really, Joni Mitchell even. I mean, she's kind of like not rock, but she was really powerful, mm-hmm. You know, stateswoman. And you know, I mean, they've always been there, and you know, more power to them. But you know, I think when it gets down to the nitty gritty of, you know, being role models and all this kind of thing, you know, I think that people should just know what they're doing and have their life, you know.
Will we expect to see Curve on tour anytime soon?
You will. In America, we'll be coming in, I presume, around the end of May, beginning of June time. And we're touring in Europe, throughout Europe, for 7.5 weeks in April. And we're doing a British tour, and we're touring a lot this year.
Okay, well, good luck with all that stuff. Yes. And right here, a video from the Curve EP, Frozen. This is Coast is Clear. Thanks for coming by.
Thanks.